Mr. President, what do you say to Americans who are worried but at the same time do not really understand what the fiscal cliff is all about? And do you really believe there will be a resolution before the year ends?
Well, first of all, it's actually not that complicated. Right now, if Congress does nothing, on January 1st, taxes go up for every American family. And for the average middle-class family, you're looking at $2,000 out of your pocket. And that means $200 billion in consumer spending that suddenly goes away because it's being taxed. Obviously, it's a huge strain on families that may already be struggling in Florida or elsewhere. And so what we've said is our first step in resolving the fiscal cliff is to do something that Democrats and Republicans both say they want to do, which is don't let taxes go up for middle-class families. Senate has already passed that bill. Democrats in the House are ready to pass that bill. And all we need is House Republicans to go ahead and say, you're right, for 98% of Americans, for all incomes under $250,000, your taxes shouldn't go up. That would take away a lot of the anxiety for most families. And we want to make sure that families tell their story about what $2,000 would mean to them. So if you've got a Twitter account, you can go to My2K. You know, it's a hashtag that allows you to tell your story. And we've collected 300,000 so far. But what we also need to do is reduce our deficit in a responsible way more broadly. That means revenue, asking the wealthiest to pay a little bit more in taxes, protecting middle-class families, and then cutting out some programs that we don't need and making some responsible spending cuts. And I hope that we can get this resolved. I'm prepared to do it. I've put forward a plan that's balanced. That's what most Americans want. We just need Speaker Boehner and the House Republicans to step up and say they're ready to get going.
Mr. President, Latinos come to this country pursuing the American dream, yet they will inherit a huge amount of debt, them and their future generations. What do you say to them?
Well, I think that's why we need a responsible debt reduction package. And we can do this without hurting our investments in things like education, protecting our seniors and Medicare. We can responsibly cut our deficit while at the same time doing those things that we need to grow. But we can't do it if people like me aren't willing to pay a little bit more in taxes. You know, we could balance our deficit just by cutting our way out of our problem. But that would mean that senior citizens would pay a lot more for Medicare. It would mean that young people who are trying to go to college might not get the same financial aid. And my attitude is they need more help than I do. And that's why we need a balanced approach.
Mr. President, regarding the past election, were you surprised that a lot more Cuban Americans voted for you than in the previous election, and to what do you attribute that?
Well, I was very pleased to win Florida, although I do want to get the results sooner next time. So that's something I want to work with Florida officials on. Yeah, we had seen a steady increase in support for me in the Cuban American community, even in 2008. I think that the outreach that we've done, some of the steps we've taken, for example, to allow remittances back to Cuba while still holding a firm line that we have to make sure that political prisoners are freed and freedom of speech and religion takes place inside of Cuba. I think that approach, that practical common sense approach to Cuba policy is something that the Cuban American community cared about. And I also think, I think the Cuban American community understands the same way most Americans understand that we're a nation of immigrants, that we should embrace our diversity, that we should pass comprehensive immigration reform, that we should make sure that our economic policies focus on middle-class families and not just folks at the very top. Mm-hmm. So a lot of the issues that are important to all Americans are also important to Cuban Americans.
One issue that Cuban Americans are worried about is they believe that you favor a socialist model for our country. Cubans and Venezuelans especially, because of what they're gone through in their country. What do you say to them?
Well, I don't know that there are a lot of Cubans or Venezuelans Americans who believe that. The truth of the matter is that my policies are so mainstream that if I had said the same policies that I have back in the 1980s, I'd be considered a moderate Republican. I mean, what I believe in is a tax system that's fair. I don't think government can solve every problem. I think that we should make sure that we're helping young people go to school. We should make sure that our government is building good roads and bridges and hospitals and airports. so that we have a good infrastructure. I do believe that it makes sense that everybody in America, as rich as this country is, shouldn't go bankrupt because they get sick. So the things I believe in are things that I think most of your viewers believe in.
Also, Venezuelan President Hugo Chavez is in Cuba. He was operated from cancer. What message do you have to Venezuelans in Miami and in Venezuela regarding the future of their country without Chavez, possibly?
Obviously, the most important thing to remember is that the future of Venezuela should be in the hands of the Venezuelan people. What we've seen from Chavez in the past is authoritarian policies, suppression of dissent, and I won't speculate on what his medical condition is, but what our policy is constantly designed to do is to make sure that you have the voices of ordinary Venezuelans expressing themselves, that they have freedom, that they're able to, if they're working hard to succeed in that country, and we would love to see a stronger relationship between our two countries, but we're not going to change policies that prioritize making sure that there's freedom in Venezuela.
Also, Mr. President, why reach out to the local media? I'm from a local TV station in Miami. Why reach out to us?
You know, one of the things that I found is so important during the course of the campaign is that, the conversation here in Washington isn't the same as the conversation out in the country. People are worrying about paying their bills, about making their mortgage, about the quality of their schools, about getting their kids to college, about big potholes in their roads, flooding, making sure that we have safe streets. And so whenever I talk to local stations, what I find is just the ability to reach more Americans. And in resolving issues like the fiscal cliff here, it's so important that members of Congress hear from people back home. So I'm hoping that if one thing comes out of this this interview, I'm hoping that people who are watching say, you know what, I want to reach out to my member of Congress and say, compromise, let's go ahead and get this thing solved. Let's think about the country first and not politics first.